ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸುಮನ್. ಟುಡೇ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆರಿಲಾಗ್ ಕೋಡಿಂಗ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ದ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಡೀಟೈಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಿ ಪಿ ಟಿ. ದೇರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ವೆರಿಲಾಗ್. ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಎನಿ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. We are just going to share the document. That one you need to go through and you need to come across the details. Okay, in this video I am trying to explain a second objective. That objective is about distinguish the syntax of Verilog coding styles. Okay, actually we are mainly concentrating on a three styles here. Okay, that is for a gate level modeling, data flow modeling and a behavioral modeling. Okay, that is the agenda of today's session. Okay, now let us see the agenda. First we are going to see about a general coding syntax for a Verilog coding, then a gate level, then we are going to see a data flow modeling, what is the major things we are going to do, then in a behavioral description how we are going to write it. Okay, then at the last we are going to do a little bit comparison, how we can able to distinguish whether the code is a gate level modeling or a data flow modeling. Okay, let us see and general coding syntax. Okay, in this Verilog module, if you are trying to write any coding, always it need to start with a module. Okay, everything we are going to call it as a module here. The module consists of a name. Okay, if you are designing any module, we need to give a name. That for naming there is a certain rules you need to follow. That rule is about always you need to start with a character name. Okay, it should not start with any numbering or any special characters. It needs to start with a character. After a character, you can use the numbering and all those things. Then you need to write in a parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis, you need to define the ports. Okay, if you have taken it, for example, timing, let's consider a simple basic gate of an AND or an OR. Okay, if you see that gate, we are having two inputs and one output. Okay, in these ports, okay, we can specify the variables what we are going to use for an inputs and outputs. Okay, just we are specifying the variables. We are not going to write whether it is an input or output. Those things also can be done inside that port itself. Those type of styling is called as an ANSI C. Here, let not go to that level. Let write it separately. Just we are going to declare the ports here. Then we are going to specify the inputs. What all the variables we have used is an inputs. Then next we are going to specify the outputs, what all the variables we are going to specify. This is the initial declaration part. At the last we are going to specify an end module. This is the general syntax we usually follow for Verilog coding. Now let us go for a gate level modeling. Okay, in this gate level modeling, what we are trying to see is, here we are able to see an this inside the design body, just we have taken an AND gate there. Okay, this AND is an inbuilt guess primitive. In this gate level modeling, we are going to use an inbuilt already available gates. Okay, in this gate level modeling, we can see an AND, OR, NOT, XOR, XNOR, buffer, NOT gate. Like already it has been defined for an gates. It has some rules. Okay, in order to call those gates, we can call that as a model, already it has been built up. Okay, you are going to call that with a model name. That names have been already known to you. If you want to call in basic gates, the name itself have been created with those things. If you want to call, you can call an OR. Okay, here I am just trying to call an AND. Okay, then I need to give an here instantiation name. It is not mandatory for an inbuilt primitives. If you are calling in any another module inside here, you need to make sure that it has an instantiation name. The best practice is always try to give an instantiation name here. Okay, for the AND gate syntax, inside the parenthesis you can see in three variables. Okay, how we will come to know which port is an input or an output. Okay, always for all the basic gates, the first port is an output, next coming ports are an input. Here I am trying to use a two input AND gate. That's why just I am trying to take it as a first port as an output, next coming ports as an input. Okay, here you can see in one and into are the two inputs for your AND gate, and out is the output. Okay, like this you can do it. Okay, like that you can write for if it is and consist of an all the basic gates. You can make use of same two inputs. You can make it as an 5 or 6 outputs. Just you call those programs and you can write. This is the general syntax for your gate level modeling. Okay, now let us go for a data flow modeling. Okay, if you see the difference from in last slide to this slide, okay, you have only the design what is changing. The overall general syntax remains the same. In this syntax, you cannot see anything and or anything like those things. I think you can see in this green color. Okay, usually in the data flow modeling, in a design body, what you are going to do is, you are trying to write with an expression type of statements. Okay, always at the left hand side, you will be having an output variable. At the right hand side, you have an input. Based on the expression, it is going to store the result. Along with that one, you need to have an assign. This is a continuous assignment. Okay, this ampersand is used for an AND gate symbol. If you want to go for an OR gate or a NOT gate, you are going to use a negation and all those signals. All those things will be explained in a next video. In this video, we are just trying to see the syntax and how you can differentiate it. This is the difference. Okay, now let us go for a behavioral. Okay, this is special type when compared to an gate level and data flow modeling. Those design bodies are going to execute parallelly. In this behavioral modeling, it is going to execute sequentially. The main difference you can see is here it has an always. This is by default you can have. Another one thing is you can have an initial always. Okay, here at the always you can see an at. It is going to evaluate the design body based on some particular events. The events, if you have just specified as an in1 and in2, whenever there is a change in the input, then only it is going to execute the lines. Okay, one small mistake I have done. Always there in the output for a behavioral modeling, it need to be written as a reg. I have been missed out. What that register is in one type of a content in order to store the data. It is going to evaluate only when there is a change in the input. Whenever there is no change, it need to retain its informations. That's why you need to declare that as a reg. Those things I will explain in the upcoming slide. Just you see the syntax here. Okay. In the inside, you can write an begin and an end. Between the begin and end, it is going to run sequentially. Okay. Now let us see the basic differences what we have found in all the different types of coding. Okay. The differences, major differences you can see is, in the gate level modeling, it is going to use an inbuilt primitives. In a data flow modeling, always you will see an assign at the left hand side part for an output variables. In the behavioral description, it consists of an always block. This is the major difference you can see firstly. Then when it comes to an execution of a design body, the gate level and data flow modeling is going to execute parallelly. Then behavioral is going to execute sequentially. Sequentially in the sense, one after the other line inside the design body is going to execute it. But in the data flow and gate level modeling, all the lines are executed parallelly. Okay, who have studied then digital circuit, they will come to know that the difference between a compilational circuit and a sequential circuit. Based on the circuit they are going to design, they need to go for an equivalent styling. Okay, next, another option is calling an another module. Inside a module, you can call an another module. That option is available in gate level and data flow. But inside behavioral modeling, you cannot call inside an always block. If you want to call those blocks, there is an another concept called functions and a task. If you have written those module function as a task or a function, you can call it. Straight away, the module cannot be called. Okay, then in the design body, what are the major things you are going to use is the basic gates, whatever it is there you are going to use in the basic gates in a gate level. When it comes to a data flow, you are going to see an expression kind. Then in the behavior also, you are going to see the same expression. Thank you.